Everybody, just a little quick update here on Pop's FBR. One of the things I'm going to try to label this video so you can see it if you're going to do a Fummins swap is to go ahead and swap out the air conditioner compressor on it. I know it's kind of expensive. Get a used one if you want to while you have it open, whatever. But I'm going with all Motorcraft in my truck. Also, one of the things you want to do is you're going to bring it up from a 6-rib belt to an 8-rib belt by upgrading to a 6.7's Powerstroke air compressor. So that'll fill up all the pulleys to where it's going to get maximum friction, because that's what was happening to mine. Is that I threw two belts in about 10,000 miles, and on a hot day, it gets it just really hot. Show you a couple of things here. First of all, let's take a look at the old truck and what it looks like now that we got it going. You hear it running? All right, well, let's take a look at it. All right, well, here's the old beast. In the old storage room here, and I'm going to show you what the old AC compressor looked like. I'm going to get it out here. It's kind of dark in here, but let's see what we can do. All right, here's the old AC compressor right here, right there. All right, let's take it out, take a look at it. All right, here she is, and show you a couple of things. So if you're having trouble keeping yours on there, look for some of these telltale signs. Here's the pulley. It is the 6-rib pulley. Notice right in here, we've got melted rubber. Okay, there's also melted rubber up here. That could be a sign either of that it's not aligned right, or that you just need more. But you can see that right here on all the six, the A rib right here wasn't being worn very much, and so it was probably had some disalignment on it. But that's not the real problem, because the real problem when it's getting hot like this, look at this, is that it's actually pulling too much work, too much duty time. See how that is? Yep. But this is, I'm going to put it up for sale, and it's still good. It's still air conditioned very well. And it has no problems. You see, it's an original. You can see some of the dye is in there still from it. But we're going to tape those off and cover those up, and it'll be ready to go for the next 6-4 guy or next Fummins dude that wants to put them together. Just a reminder that these compressors are identical compressors. The only difference is the pulley that's on them. There may be some small differences, but as far as fit, the fit's identical, so you don't have to worry about that. And so the only thing difference is the pulley, and of course we want the pulley on there to fit all six, all eight ribs. So the extra work that you, that the aqueous hub that is on there, and it's going to be pulling a little harder during during hot weather. That it's got all the friction that it can. It actually increases about 30% when you change it from a six rib to a eight rib. One other thing I want to show you is one of the differences that I made sure to do real quick. Probably noticed this whenever I was showing you the engine running, is the back side of that belt is green, and that's indicating that's a Kevlar belt, and so that way it will have much more resiliency on it. I am going to carry with me a regular belt, so if you know I'm going down the road, I have some trouble with it, I am going to keep it with me so that I can get to a point of refuge if I have any trouble. But this should take care of the problem. There shouldn't have any trouble hereafter. You'll notice also on the fan. Let's take a look at this fan. Those of you who have followed me doing this thing know you'll recognize this fan. All right, there's the fan. That is the original 6.4 fan. Have an adapter from Mike Fuchs. And that is not the original fan hub, because the original fan hub is electronically controlled. Since this is all mechanical, you have to have an aqueous controlled. So the hotter that it gets inside here, the more that it locks up, brings in more air, and that's how the aqueous works. Last thing I want to show you is most of you guys that have worked on these 08s through 10s, F-350, know that there's an extra access point for it. Let's show you this little access point, how you get this in and out. Here I am at the front right fender, and right behind the wheel, of course, there is the fender liner. Take that fender liner out, and you can see underneath there, you can get right to the compressor through there. And you can see the back side of the belt right there. All right, so well, that's my suggestion to you, is that when you do this swap, you go ahead and switch over to a 6.7 air conditioning compressor and use up all eight of those ribs. I was stranded once, 90 miles away from home. And the first one through, when I was just a little ways away from home, I was able to pull into a little convenience store and swap it out myself. Right there at the convenience store at about 10 o'clock at night. But you don't want them to do that. I mean, I built this thing so it would go long haul. That's what you want. That's what it looks like from here. Thanks for this edition of Pops Chops. We'll see you guys next time here on Pops Mother Road FBR.